We know that we have committed sins, and okay. we know that we have to confess it to God. Okay. And the next element is repentance.
Yeah.
So how do I always had this doubt whether I've actually repented of a sin. I'm not talking about any one particular sin, but I'm talking in general. Like, how do I know whether I've repented of it or not?
So repentance, if you can actually see, Harish, it's probably our three levels. Repentance. The first level of repentance is the personal, emotional level, where you feel bad, where you go through a process where you actually go through the sadness, the self despair, the sadness, and say, Lord, I'm sorry, that confession, and I repent, I want to change. Okay, so that is the repentance, the personal. And so only you will know whether you have experienced that repentance, whether you feel bad. If you're not feeling bad, if you're not actually upset about it and you're just saying, God, so I'm sorry for all my sins, that may not be repentance. But repentance actually, if you see in the story of Jonah, no, that people tear their clothes. You don't have to tear your clothes, but yeah, they fast, they pray, they tear their clothes. That is the despair against sin. So repentance is not to be taken lightly. It is sadness, deep sadness, crying before the Lord, saying sorry before the Lord, and doing that. So that is repentance. But the second aspect of repentance has to do with turning your life around. It has to do with doing something different, changing the course. Now, in certain cases, this changing the course is actually very hard and it takes a long time. So it's like, imagine if I was a drug addict and I repent, I'm really sorry, but the next day I may still want to take drugs. And then again, I repent and I want to take drugs. So the repentance of changing your life may take time and you may need help. And it may require a drastic change. But for that, you need the Holy Spirit. For that, you may need help. But it's a big change. That repentance is the life change. And you will also only know that happened if your actually life changes. If your life hasn't changed, then you haven't repented at that level. God wants you to have repentance at the feeling level. God wants you to have a repentance at the personal level where you turn your life around. But he is patient with you. He recognizes that your sin will take time, that you will take time to deal with it. So simply saying like my anger, I repent from my anger. But tomorrow I'll feel angry again and I repent and I feel angry again. But I'm trying to change my life. So I start setting up certain ways of how to not get angry. That is repentance, where I take steps to change my life around. But the third thing of repentance is social. It's the public repentance. Now, this is not to be taken lightly also. It's when the community repents, when the community asks God for forgiveness, where we ask each other forgiveness. I'm sorry I hurt you. Where we confess our sins to one another. That public repentance is also a unique event that happens in the Bible, where repentance is a community, where we all repent. It's not just about you. Now, I know Achan's sin is about that one person, but still the community has to change. The community has to repent. They has to do an action. And in that language, stoning was that action, where they had to make a strong statement as a community against that sin. So then is a larger, it's more than you. It actually affects all of us. But that is something that may not be what you're talking about. So for you, the personal, emotional, and the personal life change, which will take time. The life change will take time, but the emotions must be immediate and daily and regular. Like you will know it. Does that make sense, or do you have a follow-up question?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah. In what way does it help, and in what way does it clarify?
I assumed repentance was something that once you had a, I mean, when you go through repentance, that you never repeat sin.
Okay,
that's what I thought it was, but yeah.
It's not that you never repeat sins, but there is a sign of changing your life. There's a sign of doing things differently. And that would be the big thing that happens in repentance.